still rocking after all these years.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
This is it, the show that started it all. Often imitated, but never equal. From San Francisco, USA, online since 2004, it's the one and only rock and roll geek show with the original rock and roll geek, Michael Butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name is Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Tuesday, August 27th, 2019. It's 6:35 p.m. when I'm recording this episode. And I have to do a Mad at Dad in 25 minutes. So I need to make this quick. I started back to work today. Boy, do I miss not working. But I need the money. Unfortunately, I'm not rich, and I'm not retired, and I'm not on the dole, so got to go work. Wish I was in the mountains. Went to the Giants game last night with Ralph Miller. Had a good time. I have to apologize to Ralph Miller if he's listening, but he had great seats, too. It was club level, right behind home seat, or right behind home plate. Really good seats. And I apologize to Ralph Miller because I kept dozing off during the game, because I drove 4.5 hours from Douglas City. Soon as I got home, I recorded a Rock and Roll Geek Dog Days episode. By the way, this is day 27 of the Dog Days of Podcasting, dogdaysofpodcasting.com. So I recorded the show, took off, went straight to the game. Ralph Miller and I had several beers, and I was just running on fumes, so I kept dozing off during the game. Giants lost. It was not the best played game by either team. They played the Arizona Diamondbacks, and the Arizona Diamondbacks made several errors, but Giants made some key mistakes that cost them the game, but still was fun. Great seats. I'm going again on Thursday. I have somebody going with me now. David Benda actually finally responded. So if you heard yesterday's episode, don't bother emailing me, because David Benda is going to the game with me on Thursday. We're right behind home plate in the field level, which is like, if you happen to watch the Giants game on Thursday, they're playing the Padres. Look behind home plate. You'll see me and David Benda. I'll be wearing a Hanshin Tigers baseball cap, and David Benda will probably be wearing a Cubs hat, I would imagine. I don't know. Maybe a Giants hat. I don't know. But look for us. If you're on the TV, if you're from San Diego or in San Francisco, look for us on the tube. We'll raise a toast to you, friends. All right. Let's get through this. Let's get through this. I apologize again for rushing through this thing, but I have a show review, so let's... Hello, caller.
Good to hear.
Oh, wait. Fuck. Hello, caller.
Hello, Michael Butler.
Hello.
This is friend of the show, Brett Garsky.
Hey, Brett Garsky.
Show review for Hank Von Hell.
Brett Garsky has a blog called Old Guy at the Show. He lives in Denver. He's probably about my age, I'm guessing, but hello, Brett Garsky.
They played the Oriental Theater.
Oh, wait, let me back this up here.
Hello, Michael Butler.
Hello, Brett.
This is friend of the show, Brett Garsky, calling in. Show review for Hank Von Hell. They played the Oriental Theater in Denver, Colorado on August 17th.
Hank Von Hell played San Francisco last week when I was doing a Mad at Dad with Dave Slusher, and I didn't realize that show was last week. Otherwise, I would have been there and pushed Mad at Dad back a day. I'm kicking myself for not going, because that Hank Von Hell album called Egomania is a great album, and I heard from people who were at the show that it was a really good show. So I'm going to assume you're going to give it a rave review, right, Brett?
But before I start that, just want to know, And I just want to ask, how are you doing?
I'm super great. Couldn't be better. A little tired because I was at the game last night. Had to get up at 4:45 in the morning. Went to bed at about 11:30, so I'm on no sleep. But other than that, I'm super great. Couldn't be better.
Good to hear. Good to hear.
Thank you.
So there's three opening bands, which is a little ridiculous. But I guess that's the standard.
I'm guessing two of those opening bands were local, and they probably had to possibly sell tickets. Could have been a pay-to-play. I don't know.
The first two opening bands were local.
There you go.
And the first one was Lotus Gate. I've seen them open for several bands. Pretty much every time Pretty Boy Floyd comes in Denver, they play. So it's kind of that.
Yeah.
They opened up for, and Jet Belly opened up for Pretty Boy Floyd last year, and Lotus Gate opened up for them. So it seems like they're in every kind of show like that.
Jet Boy goes on before Pretty Boy Floyd. Interesting.
That's about all I could say about them. Also, another Denver local band called MF Ruckus.
MF Ruckus.
They were the second on the bill. And last time Hank came, he canceled because of visa problems.
Right.
And MF Ruckus, they kept the venue open and they gave a free show for that date because I guess a lot of people were coming into town and they just wanted to give them something. So I saw that show and it was really fun. It was for free and it was just a fun, spirited show. There wasn't a lot of people there, but it was a fun show. So that was back in January. So Hank rescheduled, got into the country and rescheduled the show. But MF Ruckus was fun. The lead singer's brother died like about a week before the show, so he dedicated it to a show. And they just had to name that tune on guitar, and it was a fun show with fun set that they had. A song about rehab, not the Amy Winehouse song, original, and they have a party song called "We Don't Party." It was really short, but fun set. That that band has they're trying their best. They have a podcast. Everybody has a podcast, and they also have a comic book series.
Oh, good for them!
And then after they played, band from Norway. I think they're from Norway or
Spiders,
Sweden.
Right?
They're called Spider Shake Electric. And that's about all I could say about it. They had a pretty good looking lead singer in tight black.
Oh, it was black, a girl. That girl's the lead singer, right?
Pants. But not very memorable songs. After they played, Hank Von Hell started, and the house speakers played Puff the Magic Dragon, and then he came out just all in black. And you know, he had his Alice Cooper makeup on, and he looked thinner than he did on his videos when he started out with. So I guess the road is kind of making him thinner. But you know, he still has a little bit of a gut about him. So it's funny watching a guy with a gut on him shake and dance through the night. But the show was about sold out, not about half sold out. Let's say
half
sold.
For people who don't know, Hank Von Hell, I did a Turbo Negro new album versus Hank Von Hell episode. Thanks to Stephen Blackart. Suggested it, and I was pleasantly surprised by both of those albums. And Hank Von Hell used to be the lead singer of Turbo Negro, and he quit the band and gave up music for a while, and then he came out with this album. So both bands' albums, latest albums, are quite good.
And half the crowd was the Turbo Negro fans, and I know that because they had those jackets with chapters all over the country and some around the world too. They're there because, you know, Hank Van Hell was a former lead singer. I guess they've had like four or five lead singers. So when he started to show out, I guess it's been 10 years since he's been on North American soil. And so this tour, I don't know if you've seen his social media, but he does little clips of him around the country.
Oh, I'm going to have to check that out.
The show was kind of that sense of humor. Since it was Denver, he had a bunch of Dynasty references. And the crowd was a little too young to get those references from 80s TV shows. But I guess that show took place in Denver, so that's why he talked about it. He, most of the material is from his new album, and I know that was one of your top albums last year. So those songs were great live, and he was not just going through the motions at all. He was really playing them strong. And it was a pretty good band. They're all Swiss or Norwegian, and I think there's a language barrier with them too. But they just were kind of smiling at Hank the whole time.
One of those guys in the band played in Joel, the guitar player for Featherwitch, and sometimes the Butlers plays in Vane. And one of those guys in Hank Von Hell's band, the guy who looks like a girl, filled in for the other guitar player in Vane on the Monsters of Rock cruise, this past year, but the year before. I heard the guy's like so good looking, he's like almost looks like a girl.
So he pretty much played almost all the songs from his album.
I would have loved to have been to that. Fuck.
Yeah. And I guess the ones that kind of stood out were Too High. Of course, he made a Denver marijuana reference because every band that comes to Denver has to do that. Yeah. It's kind of mandatory.
Yeah. Legalized pot.
And and I guess with his sense of humor, he went and explained why he's not running for president of the United States of America, because he wasn't born here, so he's not qualified. But then he went on to say that he's running for Emperor of America, and his first order of business when he becomes Emperor of America will be to shake his bum. And that was
That's good.
The introduction from that, and the whole band started after that. That was
bum
kind
to
of
bum
the,
great tune
kind of the end of his set. But he came back just with a guitar, and he sang Nine Inch Nails Hurt, very heartfelt version. And he's had some drug issues and things like that in his life, so he kind of apologized for things like that, and then sang Hurt, kind of the Johnny Cash version, not the Trent Reznor version. He sang came back, and I guess the final song was All My Friends Are Dead, the Turbo Negro song, and the whole crowd was singing to that. So it was a great time at the end, and he came out at the end. I got a picture with him. I'll send that picture with review. Also I wrote a little thing on my blog about it. I'll attach that as well. But overall, it was a great show. Weird sense of humor that he has, but really fun show with a bunch of really dedicated fans, not necessarily to him, but to his old band. But that's it. Stay frosty.
All right, stay frosty, Brett Garski. You too can leave me a show review or audio comment. Area code 706-621-ROCK. That's area code 706-621-7625. But the way I'd prefer you to do it is just record it on your phone and then email it to me, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com, because the voicemail number is a Skype number, and Microsoft, since they took over Skype blows, so it's not good for voicemail. So I prefer you just email it to me. Just hit voice recorder on your phone, record it, email it, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. Thank you for that show review, Brett Garski. His website is The Old Guy at the Show, brettgarskiwrites.com. I will put a link to that in the show notes at rockandrollgeek.com. All right, I'm going to close out with a Hank Von Hell tune. And then it's going to be time to do Mad at Dad. So I'm going to have to post this after Mad at Dad, most likely. Here is Wild Boy Blues from Hank Von Hell. Thanks for listening, friends. I will talk to you tomorrow.
I'm staring at the sun, and my friends are on the run. Blowing up my bridges, and I'm fiddling with my gun.
altercation. Just a fascination. Raise glass to that hot piece of ass sensation.
I'm staring at the sun and my friends are on the run. Blowing up my bridges and I'm fiddling with my gun. White boy blues, the life I choose. I'm staring at the sun and my friends are on the run. Blowing up my bridges and I'm fiddling with my gun. Here's to my henchmen, destruction of the creed and my life fulfilled. I'm staring at the sun and my friends are on the run. Blowing up my bridges and I'm fiddling with my gun. White boy blues, the life I choose. I'm staring at the sun and my friends are on the run. Blowing up my bridges and I'm fiddling with my gun.
The Rock and Roll Geek Train Wreck.